Hey guys, I am Aditya Dhakur and welcome back to my YouTube channel. So in this video, I'll show you how to use Firebase as a backend for your Flutter application and write data to Firestore.
Firestore is this flexible, scalable, no SQL database available with Firebase. So you can keep your data here and use your application to fetch data from here and write data to it. So we'll see how to use it inside your Flutter application.
A lot of people ask me like there aren't any updated tutorials for working with Flutter and Firebase. So in this series of videos, I have tried to follow along the documentation so that even if there is an update, you'll know what to change and how to adapt to these changes. Sometimes the answers too haven't been updated on platforms like Stack Overflow, etc. according to the new method. So it can get a bit stressful, you know, trying to debug. And there is this one thing I like to do is take a walk, you know, get yourself away from the error for some time, or you know, wash your face with cold water. That really helps. And there is this one product that I would like to quickly pitch in. So I got this grooming kit from Amazon. Came in this fancy box and it has a moisturizer, a daily moisturizing cream, a face wash and a scrub, which is really cool. So if you wanted to, you can get it from the link in the description. I'll have all the links in the description. And let's get started with the video.
We'll get started by first creating a database. You can start it in test mode. So this allows everyone to read and write data for the next 30 days. And then you can switch to a production mode. Or you can directly switch to production mode if you're just getting started. So I'll just start in production mode. What happens is when you start it in production mode, the rules are set to authentication. So read and write is set to false right now. What I'll do is I'll change them to true and publish these changes. So we'll take up rules at greater length, but for now it means that I am allowed to read and write without any problem. I will take up rules in a different video, but for now let's change it to true and go back to our data. So what we have here is in Firestore, the data is stored as collections. So these collections have documents within them. So how a collection works? Yeah, let's say that this is our collection. So this is a collection of all the users who use our application, right? So what happens is each collection has a document. These lines, they were meant to be straight, but let us say that these are the documents that we have. So these documents will have a certain name. We'll give them a unique user ID for each user, and these documents each will have a certain property. So what this means is, like, for example, I am a user of this application, so I will be assigned like a unique roll number. Let's say my document will be made part of this collection. Now this document will store all the properties about me, like let's say name or where I live, my address and my photo. So these are all the unique fields that it will have. So if I start a collection, I'll call it users. Now this document ID, you can set it to auto ID for now, but we'll later switch to user ID. So this would be an auto ID, and now this could have certain fields. Let us say name. So it will have my name, Aditya Thakur, which will be of type string. I can add another field which could be age. So this could be a number instead of using a string, and I can give it 90. Right. And lastly, we could add something like, let us say, notes. Okay. So this could be a string. And I'll give it a certain description about me. So yeah, I'll just save it here. So it will be more visually clear right now. We have a collection users, which has a document, and this document has certain fields. Now documents can further have collections of their own, and you can go on creating like this, but for now we'll just stick to it. So that is about how you add data to your Firebase console, but we want to see how to write data using your application. So we'll need certain plugins to work with Firebase, and we'll get started with that. Once we have the Firebase setup, let us see how easy it is to read and write data from within your application. So I'll go back to my homepage.dart, and what I will do is I will create a simple text field. Now this text field should take in some data, and it will upload this data to this collection called users. So let's try to do that. I'll, instead of having a text as center, I'll replace it with a column. So I won't be focusing much on the UI part for these tutorials, because it will be more about the backend. You can optimize the UI as per your preference. So this is like a simple UI I have made with a text field on top and a submit data button. So what I like to do is I like to create a separate class that manages database for me. So I'll go ahead and create a separate class. Then I like to create object of this class and call the method for writing and everything and authentication. We'll do that later, but for now let us go back to the documentation and check out usage for Cloud Firestore. So what we need to do is firstly import the Cloud Firestore into our Dart. Before we go into that, we need to add the dependency. Again, we won't be copying it from here. We will go back to our pub.dev and search for Firestore, because the latest, we need the latest version, right? So we have the Cloud Firestore, which is by Firebase itself, and this is the one we need. It's on 1.04 right now, and here we have it only on 0.16. so that is why I recommend going to pub.dev to get the latest version. Again, go to your pubspec.yaml and add the dependency here. Do a pub get. It should fetch all the required files. Now for web, you need to add the SDK firestore.js inside your web index.html. So we'll go over to our usage. We need to import this inside the file that we will be using it. So we will be using it in homepage right now. So I'll go back to my homepage and import this here. Alright, so once we are done with this, what we do is we create an instance of Firebase. It's Firebase Firestore, and then this is the Firestore instance that we would be using. And we'll scroll down, as I explained, collections, we have documents within this collection, and we'll scroll down to writing data. We'll do reading after this and querying data after we have written some to it. So we'll scroll down to writing data first, and we see here that there is this option for adding documents. So what we can do is we can add a user by using this method, which is add user, and this should return users.add. Now users, what this collection reference, we are referring the collection called users, and when you press the button, it should add the user. Now this should happen randomly, and we can also set an update, but first let's try to add some data here. Okay, so for now we wouldn't be tapping into the text field property. What we'll do instead is simply click on this elevated button and try to add a user. To write data to our collection, we need to first create a collection reference. So I'll type in collection reference users equals to. Now we have to use a Firebase instance. So what I'll do is Firebase Firestore dot instance, and we'll tap into the collection property dot collection and use users. Okay, so what this does is this now refers to this collection right here that we have users, and we can use it to add data to it. So how do we add data to it? We type in we create a function which will just return users.add, and then we can tap into .then property. What happens after it's successfully completed? What happens if there is an error? All right. So that's what we are going to do. So when elevated button is pressed inside my on pressed, I can go. I can make this function async. Can go await users dot add, and we can give it some data. So how this data works, actually it's a map, so you can simply use curly braces to specify what all you need. So I'll just type in name, which would go as, let's say, and then to specify that you need to put in a comma, and age, what you can use, age would be 16, let's say, and last would be note. So these should be a number, right? And last is note. I think it was note or notes. It was notes. So you can go notes and happy boy. So that's about it. And then you can give it a dot then property. And here we can simply print user added. I can close. So you can also give it for some error. If there's an error, I'll reformat the code so it's better visible to you, right? So what we have done is we've created a collection reference, and we just simply on press we are adding the users, right? So let's hot restart this. I think we'll have to start it from scratch because we have added some new libraries. We'll wait for it to run. App has now started. What happens if we click on the submit data button? So it should print user added to our console. Let's go back to our Firestore. And you'll see that a new document was created and some data was added to it, right? So we have a number as age and we have the string that we have put in, right? So that is how simple it is to add data. But it wouldn't always be, you know, like hard-coded data. So what we can do is we'll go back to our text field and tap into the onChanged property. We weren't using it so far, so what I'll do is I'll create a new string, text note, right? And I'll set this text note to this value. So whatever we type in the text field would be saved to this text note, right? And instead of having this note as, you know, static, I can use this text note. Okay, I don't need the dollar sign. I'll just use the variable asset. So yeah, now what happens is if I restart the application, okay, the application is started. I'll just go over to enter a note and I'll type in something. Right. I'll just submit data and it will read that user has been added. Now if I go back to this, so there I would see a new entry and this says note a happy boy that I just typed in, right? So it has added this as a new. All right, now in the same we have some properties we can call in set. So what set will do is we can refer to a particular document if we have its ID, and we can set these values accordingly. And we also have the update, so we can refer this particular document. Like right now it added a new document, but what if I needed to make changes to this particular document? So we can call set and update to update this. But since my documents are pretty random right now, I don't want to go into that. I just wanted to show you how simple it is to write data. What we'll do is we'll later as we go replace this document IDs with user ID. So user ID will be a unique ID for each user. And once we do that, what we'll do is instead of using dot add, we can use dot set and dot set, and inside my dot doc here I'll supply the user ID and we'll set and update the data accordingly. So we'll do that in a later video, but for now I hope it's clear how to add data. We'll also replace this name with the data we get from the authentication, so that we'll do in the future. But for now I hope the adding data part is clear. We created a collection reference and we simply use dot add to add data to it and supplied it as a map, right? So we're done with this.